tornadoes are beautiful, elegant, spectacular, magnificent, and powerful. Mother Nature is amazing. Welcome to Tornado Alley. However, you may only want to describe tornadoes in this way when they occur far away from the society, especially far away from you. Unfortunately, if living in Tornado Alley, tornadoes are just around the corner in terms of time and location. In 2011, on May 22nd, a high-intensity tornado struck Joplin, Missouri, just 200 miles away from here. And it claimed the lives of 161 people, injured more than 1,000. It destroyed numerous homes and caused $2.8 billion of property loss. Now, you may want to change your attitude towards the tornadoes. Tornadoes are dangerous, terrifying, devastating, costly, and deadly. They are disasters. That is true. Tornadoes cause an average of $10 billion of property loss each year. And in 2011 alone, the tornado-induced property loss exceeded $20 billion, and 550 people were killed. Compared with another windstorm, hurricanes, tornadoes have killed more people. This is because hurricanes show up on satellite imaging days beforehand, and hurricanes' path can be predicted and monitored on the ocean for days, giving people time to prepare for it by either reinforcing your windows or doors, or simply running away from the hurricane path. On the contrary, the generation of tornadoes cannot be predicted. Many tornadoes occur in the evening of sunny, clear days, and some tornadoes pop up at night when most people are sleeping. They are unexpected, and the average warning time of tornado is roughly 8 to 10 minutes. Can we evacuate the entire community in 10 minutes? Obviously, no way. From another perspective, due to the unpredictability of a tornado, the community may not want to be evacuated, as you never know in which way exactly the tornado will go. You may think you are running away from the tornado path. The tornado may turn around and come after you. So if there isn't a public tornado shelter in your community, the only way for you and your family to survive is to make sure the building you are in, at least a designated area of the building, is strong enough. If the building you are in is severely damaged or destroyed, it may crush the occupants, injuring or killing them. Now, your non-tornado-resistant building not only has lost the function of protecting you, but also has become a hazard-generating body. In fact, 84% of deaths during tornadoes resulted from building and structural failures. And this shows us how important it is to make your building strong enough to resist tornadoes. At this point, you may have started to think of reinforcing your house. Does this mean you are safe? Not necessarily. As a matter of fact, the flying windborne debris thrown into your house can cause enormous damage to your house. The windborne debris can come from the unreinforced houses that surround yours. And that is to say, even though you are conscious you reinforce your house, if your neighbors don't do the reinforcement, their houses can be destroyed or severely damaged, generating windborne debris. And that will increase the risk of your house being destroyed and threaten the lives of you and your family members. Therefore, tornado resistance is a matter for the entire community. To achieve true tornado resistance, we need the entire community to be alert and work together, making decisions together and acting together. At Missouri University of Science and Technology, we established a Wind Hazard Mitigation Lab, short for WHAM. And our mission is to make Tornado Alley a better place to live, since we realize moving away from Tornado Alley may not be a solution at all. And Tornado Alley may be the place where generations of your family have lived. And this is a place where families call home. But they do have the fear of tornadoes, and they do want this place to be a better place to live. To respond to this, we've been simulating the wind field generated by tornadoes and investigating the wind pressure, forces, and moments induced by tornadoes on different types of structures. However, we also realized our research may never really change people's lives until we awaken the entire community to work together. So today, I'm not talking about how to apply our research to reinforce your house. I'm talking about how to make the entire community be alert of tornado hazard and facilitate a community-wide unanimous decision on structural reinforcement using two famous theories in behavioral finance. The first one is prospect theory, developed by Daniel Kahneman, a Nobel Prize winner, and the second one is game theory. Prospect theory is applied here to help individuals make a decision to reinforce their houses. Whether or not you want to reinforce your house is like you choosing between the following two options. A, if you don't reinforce your house, it's 1% chance to lose $300,000. It assumes that we are looking at a house at the value of $300,000. 1% is like the low probability of tornado occurrence. And B, if you do the reinforcement, you lose $3,000 with a certainty. And this is the amount of money you spend to reinforce your house. It's about 1% of the house value. Which one do you want to go with? Think about it and hold your thought. Now let's see what most people are thinking. Based on prospect theory, people tend to avoid a significant loss even with a low probability. And this has been verified by a previous study. When people were asked to choose between A, 5% chance to lose $10,000, and B, lose $501 with a certainty. Even though in option A, the expected loss, the product of 5% and $10,000 is $500, very close to the loss amount in option B. People accepted the short loss of $501 due to the fear of a significant loss. Based on this theory, to convince individuals to reinforce their house, the key is to inform the entire community of the significant loss induced by tornadoes. So to achieve this, we are developing virtual reality animation to create a scenario of traveling people to a future time when a tornado strikes their community. So people can virtually and personally experience the tornado disasters. To be specific, once you provide the information on your house and the expected tornado intensity, our simulation tool will generate the wind field of tornado and figure out the wind pressure induced by tornado and find out how your house performs. And all the obtained data will be used for the development of virtual reality animation. In this virtual environment, you will see a swirling wind flow is generated, approaching your house and tearing your house into pieces if it's not strong enough, and generating windborne debris and crushing the occupants in the house. And this will be what will happen to your house when this intensity of tornado strikes your community. And this will be a personal experience of tornado disasters. So through this personal experience, you will have a better idea of the significant loss induced by tornadoes. Based on prospect theory, in order for you to avoid a significant loss, now you are willing to reinforce your house. Besides virtual reality animation, we are also doing live testing to give people an opportunity to visualize the significant loss induced by tornadoes. And so far, we'll build two small-scale tornado simulators. One is made of steel, and the other one is made of transparent glass. And currently, we are building a large-scale tornado simulator. Now, let me show you a video made by my research assistant, Ryan.
Hello, everyone. This is Ryan with the Wind Hazard and Mitigation Laboratory. As the wind speeds increase, it is clearly shown that a tornado is actually a swirling wind flow. You can clearly see how the small particles follow the swirl and demonstrate the upward and radial motion. This combination of upward and straight wind often leads to violent results. In this section, Small foam pieces are used to demonstrate the flying windborne debris that is generated by the violent winds. The windborne debris is the leading cause of death in tornadoes due to irregularity in shape and size, as well as their speed and thereby difficulty to see coming. Tornadoes are especially hazardous when their path goes through existing communities. This video shows the impact of tornadoes on communities, specifically how a high-intensity tornado can blow your house away and how the windborne debris can make the situation much worse.
Wait a minute. How about my neighbors? They need to reinforce their houses too. I definitely don't want the windborne debris from them. To address them, and we further apply game theory to help the entire community reach a unanimous decision on structural reinforcement. Game theory is about mathematical models of conflict and cooperation between rational decision makers. Since tornado resistance is a matter for the entire community, to benefit each other, to maximize each other's benefit based on game theory, the entire community has to play the game cooperatively. Let me explain this using a simple example. Assume that there are only two households in a community, A and B, and each of them owns a similar single family home, and each of them has options of reinforcing his house or not doing the reinforcement. If both A and B decide to reinforce their houses to be tornado resistant, say spending C dollar amount, the loss from each household is just a C dollar amount. It's a very small amount of loss. However, if both A and B decide not to do the reinforcement, they may lose everything, including their lives, under a high-intensity tornado. And this will be a very significant loss. Another case, if A chooses to reinforce his house, but B doesn't, A's house may not be safe even with the reinforcement, because B's inaction may expose A's house and A's family to flying debris, and which generated by B's house. But B does benefit from A's action of reinforcement, and which reduces B's loss. However, in this case, the total loss will be still much higher than the case where both A and B reinforce their houses. The last case, B does the reinforcement, but A doesn't. The total loss in this case will be similar to this case. Comparing all the four cases, only when all the members in the community make a decision together and act together, the benefit can be maximized and the loss can be minimized. So far, I wish you've already realized to protect your family and your home from tornado attacks is not your own business. It takes the entire community to play the game cooperatively. To apply our research, we'd like to get started with the school hallways. Traditionally, hallways have been used as a tornado shelter for schools. And this is because the safe room or tornado shelter may not be big enough when the school is in session, or there may not be sufficient time to transfer them here. Many of you may have already guided or have been guided or tornado drills, lining up on the hallway wall and bending on your knees like this. When you do this, how many of you have questioned the strength of hallways? And this video shows you how vulnerable the traditional hallways are.
And you're going to want to take a look at this. Incredible pictures. The moment a powerful tornado strikes, tearing apart an Indiana school, activated. You see the gymnasium suddenly flooded with outside light as pieces of its outer walls or drywall crash through the ceiling, leaving an overhead light.
Fortunately, when this happened, the school wasn't in session. To ensure the safety of our children, we may want to suggest our children's school to reinforce their hallways. And we can't imagine what their responses would be. This is a great idea, but the school has a limited budget. We have a lot of other priorities. I'm not surprised to hear this. I don't blame them, because they always think the tornadoes will never strike their school. However, if the school administrators were given an opportunity to virtually, personally experienced the significant loss of lives by transported to a future time when a high-intensity tornado strikes their school. They may change their mind and put priority on highway reinforcement. The idea of reinforcing highways can be directly applied to hospitals, nursing homes, hotels, you name it, to reduce the fatalities during tornadoes. In closing, our research is to prepare the community for future tornadoes by helping the entire community reaching a unanimous decision on structural reinforcement. The community can agree to reinforce their houses together, can agree not to do the reinforcement, but rather build a sufficient number of reliable public tornado shelters. The implementation of this research will increase the community confidence in terms of safety. When a tornado warning is issued, people in Tornado Alley will not panic anymore, improving the life quality in tornado alleys by addressing the common fear. To implement this research, it takes you, me, and everybody in the community to work together. To put it simple, it takes you, me, and everybody to build a tornado-ready and tornado-resistant community. It takes you, me, and everybody to make Tornado Alley a better place to live. Thank you.